الله أكبر 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 إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بشيرًا ونذيرًا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد واهتدى ومن يعصهما فإنه قد غوى وإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئًا فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن خير الأمور عوازمها وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. قال الله تعالى في كتابه المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My brothers and sisters in Islam, I was researching the khutab, the sermons of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in حجة الوداع, in his farewell pilgrimage. And something I realized was the importance of what the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was mentioning in those days of Hajj. And inshallah, I will try my best to share that knowledge with you all. In the final pilgrimage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he had thousands of people that have come from all around the world just to meet him for the very first time, to perform Hajj with him, to hear from him, to listen to him, to listen to the true words of the deen. So imagine the environment that the Prophet ﷺ is in. You have thousands of people that have never met the Prophet ﷺ directly. And they come from all across the world. They come with their different cultures. They come with their different backgrounds. They come with their different thoughts and ideas. And they come to see the Prophet ﷺ. So Rasulullah ﷺ, he has a few moments with them, a few days with them. And he has a few moments to reshape generations of jahiliyyah, generations of pre-Islamic ignorance. And he has the opportunity to change all of that to the pure and clear message of Islam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what he does in these moments is he tries to reshape the way they viewed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He tried to reshape the way they viewed religion. He tried to reshape the way they viewed worship. He tried to reshape the way they viewed each other in their societies. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chooses the right words when he speaks to the people. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he calls to their attention what they see around them. He chooses something so significant and so symbolic to speak about. What more than the Kaaba itself in these blessed days of Hajj? The Kaaba was initially a place where people were wronged. It was a place of business and transactions. It was a marketplace. It was a place where idols were worshipped. It was a place where jahiliyyah was at its peak. A place where the people oppressed one another. A place where people displeased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala initially. And look how Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was able to change all of that with the clear and pure message of Islam. So imagine these people. Imagine these pilgrims at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam making tawaf around the Kaaba. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says out loud, "Ma atyabaki." How beautiful you are. How pure you are. "Wa atyaba rihaki." And how beautiful your fragrance is. "Ma a'zamaki wa a'zama hurmataki." How great are you? How great is your sanctity? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is addressing the Kaaba here. He's literally speaking to the Kaaba out loud so the people can hear him. He's saying, how incredible is it? How beautiful is it? How sanctified is the Kaaba? And the pilgrims, around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they all have this connection to it. They all adore it. They adore its beauty. They adore its honor and its sanctity. How holy it is. How sacred it is. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is voicing this out loud for all of them to hear. So in order to understand the next part of the hadith, I want you to imagine something for a second. Imagine you saw the Kaaba being destroyed. Imagine you saw somebody throw rocks at the Kaaba. Imagine you saw somebody banging at the Kaaba and trying to rip its cloth. What would you do? Imagine you saw the destruction of the Kaaba in front of your eyes. How would you react? What would your plan of action be? What would you do? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, as I continue the hadith, and as he's speaking to the Kaaba, he says, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ لَحُرْمَةُ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَعْظَمُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ حُرْمَةً مِنْكِ مَالِهِ وَدَمِهِ وَإِنَّ ظُنَّ إِلَّا بِهِ خَيْرًا. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, I swear by the one in whose hand is my soul, the sanctity of one believer is more precious and more sacred in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than you, O Kaaba. His wealth, his life, his honor, and that we assume of him nothing but good. The believer is more precious in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the Kaaba. Look at the emphasis that's put here. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam swears by Allah in this hadith. And he swears that the sanctity, the life, the honor, the property of a believer is more sanctified in the eyes of Allah than the Kaaba itself. Subhanallah. Sometimes we don't really understand this. Sometimes we don't understand the true meaning of this. Sometimes we are so desensitized to all the suffering and the oppression that's happening to our Muslim brothers and sisters around the Ummah. That if we were just to envision that every time a child dies out of starvation in Gaza, or any time one of our Muslim sisters is tortured and raped in India, or any time an elderly man is killed and slaughtered in Sudan, or anywhere around the Muslim Ummah, if we were just to envision that that's the equivalent, if not more, than somebody going and slamming themselves against the Kaaba, somebody going and ripping its cloth, somebody going and trying to destroy the Kaaba. This is the reality of this hadith. This is what's going on to our ummah. This is what's going on to the ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that's humiliated and taken advantage of over and over again. This is the ummah that lost its protection, that lost its shield of Islam, that lost its iman from protecting the Kaaba and from protecting the lives of our Muslim brothers and sisters. This is the reality that we are living in today. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he continues the hadith, he mentions in his speech, he asks the people, what time are we in? What month are we in? And they say, Ya Rasulullah, we're in the month of Dhul-Hijjah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَيُّ شَهْرٍ تَعْلَمُونَهُ أَعْظَمُ حُرْمًا. He says, what month do you know that is more sacred in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than this month of Dhul-Hijjah? They respond, قَالُوا أَلَا شَهْرُنَا هَذَا. Indeed, it is this month of Dhul-Hijjah. It is this month in which the most sacred pillar of Islam is performed. It is this month where Muslims from all over the world gather and perform Hajj. And they stand around the Kaaba and make dua and cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he continues, he asks them, what place are we in? What area are we in? Is this not Mecca? Aren't we in Mecca? أَيُّ بَلَدٍ تَعْلَمُونَهُ أَعْظَمُ حُرْمًا. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, what place do you know that is more holy and more sacred than this place? And he's talking about Mecca in that context. And the people, the pilgrims, they respond, أَلَا بَلَدُنَا هَذَا. Indeed, it is our balad. It is the place where the call of Islam began. It is the place where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sanctified and made it one of the holy places. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he mentions this, he continues. He asks them, what day are we in? Is this not the day of sacrifice? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أَيُّ يَوْمٍ تَعْلَمُونَهُ أَعْظَمُ حُرُمًا. He says, what day do you know that is more sacred in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than this day, the day of sacrifice? So after the pilgrims, After the Hujjaj are on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after they heard him say this, and after they understood this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he mentions one final thing. He says,
إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى قَدْ حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ دِمَاءَكُمْ وَأَمْوَالَكُمْ وَأَعْرَاضَكُمْ بِحَقِّهَا كَحُرْمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ هَذَا فِي شَهْرِكُمْ هَذَا.
Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says that indeed, I'm telling you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made your honor, your blood, your wealth, your property more sacred to everything that I have just mentioned. Everything that I just mentioned to you. Everything that you see around yourselves. From the entire Kaaba itself, to the entire month of Dhul-Hijjah itself, to the entire place of Mecca itself, to the entire day of the day of sacrifice of Eid itself. This is the true value of a believer. It is more valuable and sanctified in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than everything I have just mentioned. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked the pilgrims, did you get what I said? Did you understand what I have just said? أَلَا هَلْ بَلَّغْتْ. Have I delivered this message to you? They said, yes, Ya Rasulullah, you delivered this message. They understood the value of the believer now. They understood how much the honor and the dignity of one believer meant. They understood that one believer is more precious in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than everything in this world. Now let's look at us. Let's look at our situation. Let's internalize this hadith. Look around us. We're the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't see any care. We don't see any care for or honor or dignity for the Muslims. We've seen the blood of the Muslims being spilt like its value is cheap. We've seen the Muslims humiliated and taken advantage of. When are we going to wake up and realize the true value of a believer? We need to move. We need to act the way Islam told us to act. We need to do what Islam requires of us. We need to call for the solutions from Islam. We need to call for the unification of the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the month of sacrifice. This is where you exert yourself. This is where you sacrifice as much as you can. Now my question to you all is, what are you sacrificing? What are you sacrificing when it comes to your brothers and sisters that are struggling and are being oppressed from around the world? What are you offering to them in a time where the rest of the world sees them as nothing? What are you offering to them when they are literally putting their lives and their honor and their possessions on the line day after day? What are you doing if you're not following the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what will we do when we are held accountable on the Day of Judgment? How will you respond? And how will you answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Now my brothers and sisters in Islam, if you haven't been sacrificing, now is the time to sacrifice. Now is the time to exert your efforts and do your best. Make the intention to strive and to put in the work. Make the intention to offer something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month. Sacrifice your time. Sacrifice your money. Sacrifice your platforms for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sacrifice your energy and do everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands. And we always keep in mind whenever we do these, we always keep in mind the ultimate goal, which is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is reaching Jannat al-Firdaus bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be used for His deen. May He make us of the ones who sacrifice and do everything we can for our brothers and sisters in our ummah. And may He make us of those who protect the lives and the wealth and the honor and the blood of our Muslim brothers and sisters. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'iri al-muslimin. Astaghfiruhu innahu wal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الأمين أما بعد فيا معشر المسلمين قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد بعدد من صلى وصام اللهم صل على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى سائر الصحابة والتابعين وعلى عبادك الصالحين. اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا منهم. اللهم ثبتنا على الإسلام. اللهم نور قلوبنا بنور الإيمان. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين وللمسلمات وللمؤمنين وللمؤمنات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة. اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة. اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة. اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة من التقتيل والتحريق. اللهم إنا نستودعك غزة وأبناءها وأطفالها ونساءها. اللهم انصر المجاهدين على أعداء الدين. اللهم أيقظ الأمة لنصرة غزة ولنصرة فلسطين والسودان وكشمير وسوريا وكل أراضي بلاد المسلمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأتم وأهم وأكبر. كل عام